Good morning, dear students. I am Dr. Srinivas Patni, Professor of Chemistry in St. Peter's Engineering College. In the last video, what we discussed? The solid fields we discussed, no? So, the solid fields from wood to anthracite. Wood, then peat, lignite, bituminous, and anthracite. Among all these things, which one is the most important material of solid coal? That is anthracite. Then bituminous. In bituminous also, three types. Semi-bituminous, sub-bituminous, bituminous. So, these are the solid fields we have seen in the last video. And today we are going to discuss about the topic is analysis of coal. So coal we have no types of coals already discussed. So today we have to discuss the analysis of coals. What is meant by analysis of coal? What is that topic today? We are going to discuss analysis of coal. Analysis of coal. To assess the quality of coal. Analysis means what? To assess the quality of coal. We have seen anthracite, lignite, peat, bituminous. So what is that? The quality is what? So to assess the quality of coal, it is subjected to two types of analysis. There are two types. So one is the proximate analysis. What proximate? Analysis and ultimate analysis. Proximate analysis. And second one is the ultimate analysis. So there are two types of analysis are there. One is the proximate analysis, other one is the ultimate analysis. So today we have to try to finish the proximate analysis. We have to complete the what topic? Proximate analysis. Proximate analysis. Proximate analysis. What is meant by proximate analysis? Proximate mean it involves the determination of moisture, determination of volatile matter, ash, and fixed carbon. So we have to determine the fixed carbon, volatile matter, moisture. That is how much percentage is there. So what is there? So one by one. So what we have to determine? There are three types. Moisture. How much moisture is contained? What is the volatile matter is there? And fixed carbon is how much? So there are the first moisture. Moisture means presence of water. Presence of water. And volatile matter. So what is the volatile matter? Volatile matter means gases. Carbon dioxide, sulfur, like that. What is the percentage? And ash. Ash is how much? You have to determine. And finally, fixed carbon. Carbon is how much? You have to determine all these things in where? In proximate analysis. Proximate analysis. So, let's discuss the one by one. So what is the moisture? Moisture is nothing but water. A known amount of finely divided powder. For example, you have to take one coal piece. So it should be dried and powdered. A sample you have to take in a crucible. In a small crucible. A dry powder. This is called what? Crucible. in this dry powder of coal. Dry powder of coal we have to take. So dry powder, a sample of dry powder is taken in a crucible. The crucible is placed in inside electric hot air oven. So where? So for example, it's an electric hot air oven. Electric hot air oven. So we have to keep in this side. This the crucible containing the dry powder carbon and kept in there in a dry electric hot air oven. So maintained a temperature is a 105 to 110 degree centigrade. The temperature should be how much? 110 degree centigrade to 105, almost 110 degree centigrade for about 1 hour. An hour. So temperature is 110 degree or 105 to 110 degree, and how much period is the 1 hour in hot air? Okay, then the crucible is cold, then after 1 hour we have to cool, then we have to cool it and keep in where? In outside? No, that is very dangerous. In outside what is there? Moisture also there. Then moisture absorbs the carbon. So immediately we have to keep in a desiccator. This is called what? Desiccator. So keep in this crucible. So desiccator means the tightly packed a box containing the P2O, phosphorus pentoxide. The phosphorus pentoxide, whatever the moisture is present inside, it absorbs the moisture, P2O point. So then you have to keep. So there is, it is very cold. So cool it. The first of all, what you have seen? The powder, dry powder taken in a crucible, then keep in electric hot air. At temperature is the 105, 110 degree, an hour. For 1 hour, the period is 1 hour. And then, after 1 hour, we have to taken from the hot oven and kept in a desiccator. Okay, desiccator and wait. The process of eating, cooling and waving. What are that? The process of eating, cooling and waving. These three words, the process of heating, cooling and then wait it. How much is there? Where the crucible? So repeatedly till the weight become constant. The weight should be constant. So we have to repeat. Constant weight should become. So now loss in weight has reported. Moisture on percentage basis. What is that? The formula is what? The percentage of moisture. So we have weight. How much? The loss of weight. Loss of weight. Divided by the weight of dry coal. Into dry coal into 100 percentage means 100. So this is become the moisture. How much moisture is present in dry coal? So the percentage of moisture is called the loss of weight divided by the weight of dry coal taken multiply with 100. So percentage will come. So similarly, we can do the volatile matter as and fixed carbon. So the volatile matter is what? Next is the volatile matter. So volatile matter. Volatile matter. So what is volatile matter? The volatile matter present in the coal may be combustible gases, such as what? The hydrogen you have seen. It's a combustible gases. And methane and carbon monoxide. So these are the combustible gases. And other lower hydrocarbons. And non-combustible gases such as carbon dioxide, nitrogen, they are not combustible gases. They are also present in the coal. Because all these are volatile. For the determination of volatile moisture, similarly we have to take, now moisture free coal you have to take care. Moisture free means this one, dry after dry. The moisture free coal you have to take. And moisture free coal is taken in a same crucible covered with a lid. Covered with a lid, same case, and keep in where? In the same electric furnace. The placed the and covered with a lid, same in a crucible, and placed in a in an electric furnace, that is a muffle furnace, and maintained it to 925 degrees centigrade. Here the moisture we have to remove at 105 to 110 degrees centigrade. But so here now in the volatile case, how much temperature? 925 degrees centigrade temperature. So we are taking the moisture free coal. You have to take sample in a crucible and keep in a hot electric oven. And how much temperature is the 925 degrees centigrade temperature or plus 20 degree for just 10 minutes. Here 1 hour, here 10 minutes. Period of time is the 10 minutes. Then similarly, the crucible is taken out and cooled first in the air. Then inside the desiccator. Similarly, the weight loss, the loss in weight is repeated volatile matter on the percentage of basis. Same here, simply volatile matter. Volatile matter. Loss of weight and weight of dry coal taken. Weight of dry, moisture free dry. Moisture free dry. Moisture free. Weight of dry coal, that is moisture free. Multiply with 100. That is about the volatile matter. Volatile matter. Okay? Now let's go to the ash. So ash, we know the ash is it what? Dust, small gray color dust. Okay, ash is a non-combustible. Ash is a non-combustible useless matter left behind after complete combustion of coal. Combustion of coal, the residual coal is so what is that? Ash is a non-combustible dust or matter left behind after that combustion, complete combustion of the coal. The coal residual, the residual coal is then heated without lid in a muffle furnace. So we have to take the after burning. So complete burning, the coal complete burn with oxygen and ash will come. This ash we have to take in a furnace. In a furnace. So this is a powder. In a hot furnace, almost 700 degree centigrade temperature we have to take. 700 degree, so without lid, don't keep the lid. So 700 degree centigrade for half an hour. For half an hour. For half an hour we have to take. The crucible or lid crucible is taken, then cool it in the air. No need to desiccator. Then later we have to keep in desiccator. First of all cool, very hot, because the hot one is don't keep in the desiccator. Then cold in the air, in the presence of air. Then after that we have to keep in a desiccator. The crucible, the desiccator and waved. Same repeatedly. What is that? Heating, cooling and waving. These three are repeatedly. The crucible is taken out from the desiccator, cool first in the air, then in a desiccator and waved. Heating, cooling and waving are repeated till constant weight is obtained. The recipe reported as on the percentage of base, same percentage of ash. So here we have to take the, here the weight of ash. Here don't take the loss of weight. So here the weight of ash. Weight of ash and weight of dry coal taken multiplied with the 100, we will get the percentage of ash. Okay, now next, fixed carbon. After the determination of moisture, volatile matter and ash content, the remaining material is fixed carbon. What is that? We have determined the moisture, volatile matter and ash content. The remaining material is known as fixed carbon. So remove the moisture, remove the volatile matters, ash. So what is there inside? That is the carbon is there, that is fixed carbon. It also represents the quantity of carbon. It also represents the quantity of carbon that can be bound by primary current of air drawn through the hole by the fuel, or bit of a fuel. The higher the percentage of fixed carbon, the greater is the calorific value. So if the percentage is very high, the fixed carbon percentage is high, the quality is also quality, because the percent quality is high, because it is having the high calorific value, So simply we can, the percentage is how can you draw percentage? The percentage of fixed carbon, percentage of moisture, percentage of volatile matter and percentage of ash. You have to remember all these things. Then we will get the fixed carbon percentage. Okay? And then significance of analysis. So what is meant by significance of analysis? Just listen. The proximate analysis gives a quick and valuable information. This is a very good valuable information. And regarding commercial classification, we have to, what is what, which one is the anthracite, which one is the peat, which one is the bituminous coal. So like that we have to classify. And suitable of the coal for industrial use. So we have to indicate for this power plant, home made, like that we have to distribute. So that is the very significant case. And it consists of a complex mixture of gases and liquids of resulting from the thermal decomposition of coal. So inside is what? Thermal decomposition. If the, so many gases are there inside. Underground, the coal along with the coal and other gases like hydrogen, methane, carbon dioxide and many material minerals also present. Everything is attached with the carbon. So the amount of decomposition and yield volatile matter. Decomposition means, so volatile matter depends on the conditions of heating and particularly temperature. The how much of temperature inside is there, that is very very important. Okay. And moisture, we have to look the moisture content is how much, and volatile matter and same ash and all these things we have to determine the all these things, moisture, volatile and everything, then the quality will come. So for example, moisture, a moisture content in the fuel takes some heat liberated in the form of latent heat, which reduces the calorific value, because the moisture is present, the calorific value is decreases. So I mean, increase the cost of transportation. If it's a less quality, we have to transport. So if instead of fixed carbon, it is a one lorry equal to this one. For example, 10 lorries, one lorry equal to this is the 10 lorries. The calorific value is same. In the moisture content, coal, 10 tons, for example, 10 tons. Here the 1 ton. So 10 tons equal to 1 ton means the transport charges increased. I mean the cost also increased. I mean the wastage is too much. Okay? Hence the lesser the moisture content, better is the quality of fuel. What is that? So we have to take the moisture, dried. The moisture content should be less. The moisture. The lesser moisture and better quality. But more moisture up to 10% produce a uniform fuel bed and less plush ash. So taken at least 10% is not taken. So don't take the 50%, 70% moisture, the water. So that is, it's not good. Like that, similarly, volatile matter. So we have to see the volatile matter. Volatile matter, it is also what? It is the due to the combustion, volatile means hydrogen, methane, like that. It's a combustible gases and non-combustible gases also. Carbon dioxide and nitrogen, they are the non-combustible. They are mixing, is there. Combustible gases and non-combustible gases. A lump of coal containing the high volatile matter. For example, a lump of coal. So, in this, what is there? Inside the combustible gases and non-combustible gases. Combustible and non-combustible. Non-combustible mean nitrogen, carbon dioxide, air hydrogen, methane. So these are the combustible gases. So all these things present in where? In a lump. In a lump of coal. So all these volatile matters. Along with the flame, carbon fixed. High smoke will come. Because the non-combustible means smoke will come. It's useless. Smoke will come. Mean the design of the furnace in the higher volatile matter. So lot of smoke will come if moisture and everything, volatile substances present. The greater the combustion, space required. Mean the combustion, so here the smoke will, so that furnace should be high. Big furnace we have to take. So this is about the volatile matter. Like that ash. Ash is also a residual and incombustible matter. It is an incombustible matter produced burning of coal. When it's after complete burning of coal, the ash will come. It creates a cleaning and disposable problem. What is that? Lot of ash will come. So where we can dispose it? The disposal problem will come. As the adds impurities in the metallurgical operations, it obstructs the flow of air and heat. It's a big problem, ash problem. So, for example, you have seen in the Ramagundam area of Adilabad district. So, lot of ash is there. Because that ash is present, they are using thermal power, the generation of power, they are using the coal. And lot of ash, some mountains like that, you have to go in the train, I have seen while traveling to Delhi, left side or right side. So, some places, white mountains are there. The white mountains are called the ash, big white mountains. Whenever you have to go to the Manchiral district, then you have to see the ash mountains are present near the thermal powers. Because what is that? The coal, after coal burning, they are using the water vapor, then the calorific value, a lot of ash will come. That's a waste, lot of waste. So what is the ash is reduce the heating value of coal. The ash, if the more number of ash is present, the heating value of coal is reduced. So ash content increase the cost of transportation. If more number of ash is there, the cost also increases. And on handling problem, storage problem, and disposal problem, everything is a problem. So it determines the quality of core. It determines the quality. As the lesser the percentage of ash, better is the quality. So ash should be less. So if lesser percentage of ash, it's a better quality. So all these things we can analyze. And finally, that is very, very important, is what? Fixed carbon. Fixed carbon. The higher the fixed carbon in lump of a coal, the higher percentage of coal present in a lump. You have to take one lump. The greater it's the calorific value. So what is that? If higher percentage of fixed carbon. Higher the percentage of fixed carbon. What is the greater? Greater is the calorific value. Calorific